Firstly, I want to take this opportunity to send my condolences to the families who have suffered so much with the loss of their babies' lives, and want to recognise the commitment the families have made to seek answers and seek justice on behalf of their children and indeed other families. They have fought tirelessly against a health system that wouldn't listen and wouldn't act. The treatment they received after their already traumatic experience was abominable. And it is thanks to their perseverance that we may be on the road to a more accountable health service and a safer one. I welcome this PMB as a call for action from the government, a demand that addresses the serious inadequacies in our health system once and for all, and to hold itself and its agencies directly accountable to the families who suffered gravely by this neglect. I also want to take this opportunity to discuss the ongoing problem of access to antenatal health services in my own county of Donegal, particularly with the closure of the Dunloe Antenatal Clinic. This clinic has been closed since November of last year due to a consultant going on sick leave. The post has not been reinstated since and access to antenatal services has been confined to Letterkenny Hospital. This clinic serves catchment areas from Fintown to Dunfanaghy and the wider Rosses area, including offshore islands such as Arranmore. Patients have had to travel to Letterkenny to avail of antenatal services as a result of this closure. And this is in a constituency where public transport is poor to non-existent, and the journey to Letterkenny can take up to 3 to 4 hours. It is even more difficult for rural communities to adapt to such sudden changes. I want to recognise the hard work of GAN, the campaign group on the issue, which has fought very hard to have antenatal clinic in Dunloe reinstated. And they feel this is a very real lack of a sense of urgency on the issue and a lack of understanding of the health needs of people in rural Donegal. The usual picture is emerging for these families attempting to face the big bureaucratic institution that is the HSE, long stretches of waiting to hear back from the HSE or receive any correspondence, protest after protest organised to generate response, eventually meetings with the HSE with little action or little positive news. And while there is a review pending to see if services will be reinstated, they're still no closer to getting anywhere near this. And these families are continuing to seek a solution to this ongoing issue and feel as much has been done. And so I call on the government to proactively respond to the urgent needs of all families around this country.
Thank you. And I call on Deputy Michael Fitzmaurice. You have 2 minutes, Deputy.
Good